part two of this, preparing the skin for tanning, is to remove all this, the membrane and any meat that's left on. There are some areas like up here where there's still actual meat left on the meat, on the hide. So we need to move all of that. Now I've started on this little area here, just so you can see what we need to remove, okay? And you can see I'm working backwards. So the way I do it, it's gonna be awkward for you to, because I'm gonna be in the way. But I hold the skin taut and then pull it back, okay? And just work one area at a time. And then be systematic and just work through the whole skin until you've got it all off. It's hard work, it takes a lot of time. Now I'm using an all stainless steel knife here, where the camera is. It's a full stainless steel knife I'm using. Reason I'm using this is it hasn't got a sharp edge. It's one of our kitchen knives that I haven't sharpened in a while, so this one needs sharpening, but I'm less likely to tear the hide. If I use one of my own knives, my bushcraft knives, which are much sharper, I'm likely to cut into the skin, and I don't want that to happen. So this is due to be sharpened, it's dull, so that's what I'm using it for. And you can be quite tough with a hide, you can really work on it, okay? And the cleaner you get this skin, the better your tanning process will be, the better your finished product will be, okay? So it's worth spending your time and doing this. And when you come to the edges here, okay, just work to the side and actually run straight off the side, okay? Just run it straight off the edge, okay, like that. Now this process, just see, it's hard work and takes a while, but it's worth persevering with it, because you'll get a much better product if you do this thoroughly and properly. So so I'm going to keep working on this skin, and basically once I've finished it, or virtually finished it, I'll come back to you and show you the finished results. But otherwise it's going to be a really boring video watching me do this for the next hour or so. So I'll catch you in a bit. Right, we're nearly at the last bit of body to deflesh. Still got the head to do. Now, different people have their own views about doing this. I've always personally found it better to do it with a dull knife, because I'm able to scratch a lot harder at the hide and less chance of me tearing it. Some books say a sharp knife, and some people have said a sharp knife, so I think it's a case of find what works for you. Traditionally, they would have used the shoulder blade of something like an elk or a deer and use that to scrape the hides. Sometimes this can actually be easier when if you sort the animal first and then leave it, say, for a day or so, and then do this, because it draws some of the moisture out of the hide and it makes it easier sometimes to get the skins off. But as I want to try and get this done in one day, I'm doing it obviously fresh. And don't be under any illusion. This is hard work. It's hard work on your hands. It takes a lot of time. The washing machine part of the tanning is very quick compared to using brains or chemicals or eggs. Now, you can do that in a couple of hours. But this part, I don't know of a better way of doing it. I know there are machines out there you can buy for doing it. I haven't really looked into it. I know they're available from the States, but I think you'd have to be doing quite a few skins to warrant paying for it, I'd have thought. So you can see the sort of stuff we're removing. Obviously this wouldn't ever tan, so you need to get all this sort of fat and stuff off the hide. And the reason there's so much moisture coming out on this board is because once we'd finished skinning it, I actually washed the hide. Do it for a couple of reasons. Basically, this hide particularly, because it was so much blood from the injuries, that it just makes it easier for me to work with and stops marking everything and getting it all stained. And secondly, I believe it helps by removing as much as blood. I think it helps when you come to tan the hide as well. Obviously, blood contains a lot of protein, and I find it helps. So. Get the camera. So there's our hide so far, so it's all cleaned up, all the way up until we get up here now to the neck. So we've now got to work up on the head end. Okay, so now we've got the hide and we've skinned it and defleshed it all the way through. Okay, so turn it over. And show you what we got. Okay, so there's the fox head. Running down, you can see left over one of the legs and the tail at the back there. Now, to get to this, just this point of the process, it's now 3:15, so I've been on this for something like 4 hours. I've probably spent an hour doing the head, hour doing the body, or probably longer than that doing the body, actually, maybe a couple of hours, I suppose, on the body, hour on the head, to get to this point, okay? So, defleshing the hide, it's hard work, okay? It takes a lot of time, a lot of persistence and patience to clean it up. If I could find a fast way of doing this, then I would, but I haven't so far.